Dear students, previous classes we will discuss about transport in plants includes diffusion, facilitated diffusion, water potential, osmosis and plasmolysis. Dear students, today we are going to discuss about imbibition. What is the meaning of imbibition? Compared to imbibing capacities in pea seeds and wheat seeds. Dear students, first of all we will discuss about the meaning of imbibition. So dear students, imbibition means the water is absorbed by seeds and dry roots is done by imbibition. The water is absorbed by dry seeds and dry wood is done by imbibition. Dear students, the water is absorbed by solids at the surface of the colloids by means of water is absorbed by seeds and dry roots So next one, imbibition is one of the diffusion. This is a slow process. This imbibition is always depend upon to the concentration gradient by means water molecules move higher concentration region to lower concentration region. So next one here, different organic substances have to different imbibing capacities. Several organic substances are here. These several organic substances have to different imbibing capacities. But here mainly observed two organic substances. So such as one is pea seeds, second one is wheat seeds. Pea seeds, that is golden pea plant or Physalis sativum, belongs to family Poppaceae or Leguminaceae, and another one is wheat seeds, that is Triticum aestivum, family belongs to Poaceae or Gramineae. Dear students, pea seeds are have to more proteins, wheat seeds are have to more carbohydrates or starch material. So these seeds compared to high imbibing capacities. So here pea seeds are have to more proteins, at the same time are have to high more imbibing capacities. Other than the wheat seeds. Hence the proteinaceous pea seeds, so swelling more on imbibing. Other than the wheat seeds. That is, wheat seeds are have to more carbohydrates and starch, but have to less imbibing capacities. Dear students, proteins have high more imbibing capacities other than the carbohydrates. That is, pea seeds and wheat seeds. Hence, the proteaceous species swell more on imbibing other than the wheat seeds are starch materials. Wheat seeds are starch materials. This is the imbibing capacities of wheat seeds and wheat seeds. Next one here, water potential gradient between the absorbent and the liquid imbibing for essential imbibition. Water potential gradient is always depend upon to the or between the absorption of material and the liquid imbibing is always essential for the imbibition. Is always essential for the imbibition. So dear students, so the dry seeds and dry wood and other such materials have more water potential. This water potential is always differentiated or between of the absorbed and the liquid imbibing of the imbibition, essential of imbibition, essential of imbibition. This is a short notes on imbibition. This is a short notes on imbibition. Next one here, we are going to, so how to water absorb in plants, how to water absorb in plants. Dear students, mainly the root of the root ends is always absorbed by water and mineral nutrients. Dear students, the responsibility of the root ends is role main function, that is absorb of water and mineral nutrients through upward the xylem, remaining transport to all parts of the plant body, all parts of the plant body. So these root heads are in thin wall, these root heads are in thin wall in the root epidermal cells, in the root epidermal cells and extensive appendages, extensive appendages. So these root ends is always absorbed by water, mineral nutrients along with solutes. So once root ends are absorbed by water and mineral nutrients, so these water and mineral nutrients is always done in the deep to be root pots, to be root pots in the two pathways or in the two systems. First system are here apoplast, second system are here symplast. Okay, now dear students, this is a 1 TS of root system. So TS means transverse section. This is a one transverse section of root system. This transverse section of root system consists of mainly three parts. First one is epidermis, second one is cortex, third one is steel or grass clad system. That is xylem and phloem. Remaining parts, so root ends, next one here cortex, next one here endodermis and containing phosphorin strips, and next one here pericycle and includes xylem and phloem. So dear students, how do plants absorb water and mineral nutrients? nutrients. In this question to be answer clearly, every part of the roots containing rootlets, these rootlets responsible to mainly functioning in absorb of water and mineral nutrients. So these rootlets to be developed to root of the epidermal cells, root of the epidermal cells. So these rootlets are thin walled and extensive appendages, and to be clear a long with the surface, to be clear a long with the surface is always absorption of water and mineral nutrients, is always absorption of water and mineral nutrients. So these rootlets is always absorption of water and mineral nutrients along with the solutes, along with the solutes. So these water and mineral nutrients is always moved, is deeply, is moved deeply into the two systems or two pathways. First system are here apoplast system, second system are here symplast system. By means the water and mineral nutrients to be reached upward the xylem through the plant of the all parts in the apoplastic system and symplastic system. Symplastic system. First we are going to discuss about what is the meaning of apoplast and what is the meaning of symplast. So dear students, apoplast. So apoplast is the connecting system of the cell wall and intercellular spaces of the plant body. This is a apoplastic pathway. This is a symplastic pathway. Totally will be diagram representation of cross section of one dicot group. Cross section of one dicot group. So mainly absorption of water and mineral nutrients from the soil. Main rootlets, the root of the rootlets. The root of the rootlets is always absorption of water, mineral nutrients, along with the solutes from the soil. From the soil. So, dear students, so this is a apoplastic pathway. This apoplastic pathway connecting system of the cell walls, connecting system of the cell walls and intercellular spaces and intercellular spaces. This is a intercellular space. So dear students, this is a epidermis. Epidermis containing rootlets below the 3 to 4 layers of cortical cells. 3 to 4 layers of cortical cells. These cells are loosely arranged. These cortical cells are loosely arranged. So gap between the one cell to another cell, gap between one cell to another cell, that is known as intercellular spaces. That is known as intercellular spaces. Okay, now dear students, the root of the rootlets absorb water and mineral nutrients. These water and mineral nutrients passing through the cell of the cell walls and intercellular spaces, cell of the cell walls and intercellular spaces of the cortical cells. Cortical cells. So this cortical cells to be stopped. Why? Because the last of the cortical cells to be developed to endodermis. This endodermis containing cross-permeable strips. These cross-permeable strips are not permeable into the water. Are not permeable into the water. So these water molecules and organic substances to be stopped to the inner cortex of the cortical cells. This is a apoplastic pathway. By means, in this apoplastic pathway, the rootlets absorb water and mineral nutrients. These water and mineral nutrients through the cell of the cell walls and the intercellular spaces. Through the cell of the cell walls and the intercellular spaces. Okay, now, so this apoplastic pathway is always dependent upon the concentration gradient. Concentration gradient. By means water and mineral nutrients move higher concentration region to lower concentration region. And in the thermoplastic pathway, the water molecules is always flowing of the mass flow. Is always flowing of the mass flow. There is no requirement of energy, or there is no requirement of ATP molecules. ATP molecules. And the water molecules is not depend upon to the across the cell membrane. Across the cell membrane. This is a apoplastic pathway. Apoplastic pathway. Next coming to symplast. What is the meaning of symplast? It is the system of interconnections of protoplast by means of plasmodesmata. By means of plasmodesmata. Symplast is one of the system to be interconnections of protoplast. That means neighboring cells of the cytoplasm. Neighboring cells of the cytoplasmic strands. Neighboring cells of the cytoplasmic strands to be developed plasmodesmata. To be developed plasmodesmata. By means of the water and mineral nutrients passing through one cell to another cell to be there cytoplasm. To be there cytoplasm. Okay now, dear students. So this is a symplastic pathway. So the root of the root is absorb water and mineral nutrients along with the solutes through the epidermal cells and cortical cells. Epidermal cells and cortical cells of the cytoplasm and to be reach of the endodermis of Casperi strips and to be reach of the pericycle and finally reach the vascular tissues of the xylem. Finally reach vascular tissues of the xylem. In this symplastic pathway, the mainly involved cytoplasmic strands, mainly involved cytoplasmic strands, that is plasmodesmata, plasmodesmata. By means neighboring cells of the cytoplasmic strands to be developed to plasmodesmata. This plasmodesmata are always helping in the one cell of the water and mineral nutrients to be transported easily another cell. So this is a symplastic pathway. This symplastic pathway is always depend upon to the concentration gradient. Is always depend upon to the concentration gradient is also. But easily move to the water and mineral nutrients. Root of the root is to upward the xylem. Upward the xylem. So, dear students, so the inner cortex of the inner boundary cells to be modified endodermis. To be modified endodermis. These endodermis are having to band of the subarian strips. Band of the subarian materials is appeared. That is known as Casperian strips. Okay now. The inner cortex of the internal part are known as endodermis. Endodermis are having to Casperian strips. What is the meaning of Casperian strips? So Casperian strips is one type of band of subarian matrix. Band of subarian matrix or subarian material that is known as Casperian strips. This Casperian strips is always prevent of the water molecules. Is not permeable to water molecules. In this time, these water molecules directly reach to the wall regions. Reach to the wall regions. Thereafter to be transport of water and mineral nutrients through the pericycle and finally reach of the xylem. This is a symplastic pathway. Dear students, mainly differences between apoplastic pathway and symplastic pathway. Apoplastic pathway, the water and mineral nutrients is always transported within the cell walls and intercellular spaces. There is no involvement of without across the cell membrane. Symplast, the water and mineral nutrients is always transported within the interconnections of protoplast by means of neighboring cells of the cytoplasmic strands to be having plasmodesmata, Finally, the water and mineral nutrients is always passing through one cell to another cell within their cytoplasm, So within the help of across the cell membrane, in apoplastic pathway is easily applicable in smaller size of the plants such as herbs and shrubs. In symplastic pathway is easily applicable in mid-size of the and larger size of the trees. Dear students, apoplastic pathway, the transport of water and mineral nutrients through the cell walls and intercellular spaces of the particle cells to be stopped. But in this symplastic pathway, the transport of water and mineral nutrients to be reached root of the nucleus to through the epidermis to intercellular spaces of particle cells, endodermis, pericycle, finally reach of the vascular tissues of xylem. Okay, now this is a short course of inhibition. This is a short course of apoplast and symplast. Okay, now thank you.